that time of year again. Kool-Aid Man, you ready for Christmas?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. All I really want for Christmas. All I really want for Christmas. All I really want for Christmas. Is everything on my list, baby? All I really want for Christmas. All I really want for Christmas.
Welcome to Podzilla After Dark on the Podzilla 1985 Network. It's, yeah, we're good now. It is a couple days before Christmas. This is our last show before the new year. Are you guys doing a nerd up on January?
Sunday?
Yeah.
Well, we're doing one this Sunday.
Oh, you are doing one on Sunday?
Yeah, because, it's the
23rd. Then this is not the last show before the break.
Because we're going to do one this Sunday, but we're not going to do one the following Sunday.
Okay, so Sunday will be the last show of the year.
Yes.
Okay. Important note from Egon. My name is Shannon Young. I'll be your host tonight along with Jesse Kimball.
Hey, that's me.
Also returning for the third week in a row, the Big D Dalton Anthony.
Yo.
Lindsay Wolfgang.
Hi. That's not how you say my name.
And Mandy Kennedy. Mandy, not in a good mood, is drawing.
Not just because of Dalton.
No. Well,
I haven't
Dalton's
done anything.
Dalton's a significant factor.
It certainly doesn't
how?
Help.
It is. I said I wasn't going to be on the show if he was here, and he's fucking here. So.
What did I do?
Apparently you existed.
You have thrown off the balance.
How?
It's because you beat her young Link.
He's not wearing the right color socks.
I'm not wearing socks.
What the fuck does that mean?
I can't go into detail.
Yes, you can't.
No, the real problem is, with Dalton here, like, nobody else gets to talk.
It's really true, and I have to experience this on Sunday. Every fucking Sunday.
Where are you saying that Dalton talks too much?
Yeah.
Between the three of us, yeah.
I'll try to talk less on the show.
Dalton needs to be a fifth, and he's acting like a third, which is what he usually is.
Yeah, you're a guest on this one.
Well, I know what I'm doing this entire show.
I should have said
now.
This during the pre-show.
I'm not going to talk. I'm angry.
Jeez.
So you can talk in my place today.
Got it.
Jeez. Well, tonight's show.
Merry Christmas!
Can't you feel all the Christmas joy through the table?
You know what? If dicks weren't dicks when co-parenting and making life easier for your child, then fuck, I'd be in a better fucking mood.
Not me. That one wasn't me.
No.
God, no, I don't co-parent with Dalton. Fuck that.
Well, shit, that was supposed to be a cute joke, and then you turned it mean.
Speaking of dicks and Chad.
We haven't mentioned Chad yet.
We did in between the pre-show and the regular show, which is unfortunate. There was another incident where Chad's cousin, so it wasn't Chad, his cousin Jerome, I introduced him to my girlfriend, who was Ivy at the time. And I was like, Jerome, this is Ivy. Ivy, this is Jerome. And Jerome looks at her, the first thing he says
is, oh, I know where this is going.
You suck dick. And she did while you slept.
Story.
Yeah. Remember that movie that while that you one? Were sleeping? It was completely different. This was a different version. Didn't have Sandra Bullock in it. It just had an overweight girl.
Oh.
I don't think Sandra Bullock did that in that movie.
No. My cousin Ryan said that Ivy, that he should have given her some kibble. He used to call her the dog-faced gremlin.
God damn.
Yeah. Youth is mean.
Your friends were very mean to you.
I thought tonight we would do a year in review of stuff, but let's not. Let's just throw it out the window and save it for another show. Let's just talk.
Why don't we do the year in review?
Because I didn't plan anything. Did you guys plan anything?
Yeah, I mean, like,
just now threw a list together, but I didn't put thought into it.
I feel like it's gonna be pretty easy if we just go with like, what was your favorite video game of the year? What was your favorite movie of the year?
I guess. Yeah, I guess we don't have to have anything like specific.
Video games came out this year.
We'll get to that in a second. Tonight's show is brought to you by Nutmaster.
Not my ring name.
It is now.
You have
is that PG-13?
Yeah,
we can make it there.
You haven't experienced flavor until you've had Nutmaster in your mouth.
Yeah, see,
wow.
Dalton can come out with like some walnuts and like a nutcracker,
but two of them.
He could just you could be like Diddy Kong and have a little peanut gun.
Yeah,
I am the Nutmaster.
And the adults will think it's hilarious. The kids will laugh. It'll be fine.
You could be the new Sarge. You could be like dancing with little girls.
Oh, God. No. It's never a little girl, by the way. It's always a little boy.
You could have money stuffed in your G-string by a fucking 8-year-old.
That's, yeah.
That's weird.
Maybe that's the new ref, Double H.
Wow.
And I know my Mandy doesn't like me because of you.
What?
It has nothing to do with
you.
Shannon.
Give me way too much power. I don't have nearly as much influence as you people think. Yeah. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
Nobody should worry about it.
Tonight's show also brought to you by bad parenting.
Yeah. Fuck that guy.
And the letter R.
Why the letter R?
Are you going to the mall later?
No, because it's going to be closed.
No, it won't. It'll be open. Goddamn, are we all just messaging each other now?
Are we?
No,
I haven't messaged anybody.
We can't say it on the air.
I haven't messaged anybody.
Oh.
Except for Shannon.
I don't know why we've gotten to a point now where we try to censor ourselves on the show. Before, we used to burn bridges every day. Every show, somebody was pissed at us. You remember those days?
Yeah.
That's what the Mr. 100 started from.
Yeah, well, Mandy's got a text because her phone just fucking lit up. Oh. Did you call it the Nutmaster?
No, I feel like now I feel bad.
Dalton, ask her about the first time she performed it. You'll make you feel better.
Hey, Mandy. How are you doing tonight?
Oh, that's a bad question. You should have asked my question.
You would have gotten a less angry response.
Yeah.
Of course, interrupting Mandy before she could respond is likely to make the next response much angrier.
No, because I'm going to ask her a good question. What are you drawing? She's smiling, at least.
Whatever. There's no fucking video for these bitches.
God.
Wow. Just called the fans these bitches.
They like it.
It's true.
I know who listens to us. They like it.
Sadomasochist.
Our most successful episodes are when Mandy says like horrible, crude things.
And we still have a lot of time left.
Yeah. It's been like 3 minutes. It may have felt like an hour, but it's been very short a time. I guess we're going to do the year in review show tonight. But first, we do have Dalton, you had a motherfucker of the week.
Well, I had one, and then about 130,000 of them upstaged that one motherfucker of the week.
Who's the original?
Square Enix. How the fuck are you going to release a Japan-only exclusive system, give GameStop like 4 hours to sell a couple of them, and then you can't buy them anymore?
When
people were wanting this for how long?
Yeah, like it's pretty stupid that...
I would say it's Nintendo, but it's not.
No, it's just Sony and Square.
One of their opportunities to print money, and they chose not to.
Yeah. So fuck those guys.
Who's your other?
The 130,000 motherfuckers that donated to the build a wall.
150,000 now.
But then they build a ladder.
That if that gets passed, I will start a GoFundMe for a ladder.
There is one, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, there is? Oh, damn it. Somebody's funny.
So here's the funny part about that. So what Dalton is referring to is that a gentleman by the name of Brian Colfage, I don't know, some
$8 million richer motherfucker is what he is.
He's a Purple Heart recipient, triple amputee veteran. So the dude's been at, like, the dude is an American. And he has started a GoFundMe, which you can find at GoFundMe.com/TheTrumpWall. And he is looking for $1 billion to help fund the wall between Mexico and the United States.
The one that Mexico is going to pay for.
Well, the record, we're at $9 million now.
Jeez.
I literally checked it like an hour ago.
They have raised $9 million in 3 days.
So a bunch of dumbasses have decided to give their cash to a private individual so that he can make a private donation to the Trump administration.
Also, update as of 7 hours ago by Brian Colfucker. Tune in tonight. I'll be on Fox News with Laura Ingraham's show to discuss the border wall. GoFundMe, 10 p.m. Eastern. I'm also going to check and see if the top donation is still what it is.
He's hoping. He said that if the 63 million people that voted for Trump each pledge $80, they could build the wall.
Well, here's the thing. Right now, the highest donation. Lindsay, what's the highest donation at?
I'm not repeating it because it's stupid.
Oh, you know what? All right, Mandy, you weren't here for this, were you?
Nope.
All right, what was the highest donation? Take a guess.
Well, you're probably talking fucking crazy like 100,000 then if it's ridiculous.
Close. She is the only person that guessed over.
Wait, over, I thought it was 150,000. Or was it just 50,000?
It was just 50,000.
Just 50,000.
By an anonymous person. Because again, if I'm donating $50,000, y'all fuckers are going
to
know.
The funny part is you motherfuckers can't get off your ass to donate to the homeless or any other fucking charity, but you'll send $9 million to Donald Trump to build a fucking wall that won't work.
No joke.
You know where this $9 million could go that like Brian might actually get to see?
Where was that?
The Wounded Warriors Project.
That's true.
Right. Like, didn't Trump cut like stuff from veterans too?
Yeah, he did.
So much.
But let's build him. Fucking idiot.
Build a fucking wall. See, and it's shit like that. And that's why I'm just like, Square Enix gets a pass.
And Mexico paying for it, though.
Yeah, Mexico's going to pay for this wall.
Well, they're going to pay us back.
Yeah, we're going to float them $9 million.
Donald Trump messaged Brian Stubbs and said, give us $9 million. Give us the money for this now, and we will repay you for it.
And
oh, God,
I'm
just pulled
gonna,
a Pete Davidson, didn't I?
And then
I'm going to have to make a fucking apology to this guy.
And then I'll claim that I'm the one that donated the anonymous $50,000. And then
a bunch of people
will
be like,
be
I am
associated
Spartacus.
With this. Okay.
If I get $50,000.
I want to clarify, because legitimately, like, if there are any veterans that listen to this show that maybe are offended by what I said or what we are saying about this person, like, I have no doubt that this dude, served his time and has a right to his opinion. Like, I have no problem with your political beliefs. But this wall is not going to work. There are so many better things that this money could be put toward than this wall, which will not work.
There's a reason that Trump couldn't get the wall passed while he controlled the House and the Senate. People keep blaming fucking Democrats. Democrats haven't had any control in the last 2 years.
Yeah, they had no power. They could have. It was Republicans who voted it down. Republicans who said, this is not going to work, Donald. Mm-hmm. But Donald, he's running on the promises kept platform.
Wait a minute.
So he has to spout this bullshit. But man, don't get roped up in this nonsense, because if you donate that money to them, you are not going to see that wall.
Uh-uh.
No.
Ever. Well, I don't think this is a scam, by the way. I don't think this guy's trying to scam anybody.
No, I
think
don't.
He legitimately thinks he's making a difference,
well, yeah,
but it's not.
Because Brian Colphage, if we're saying your name correctly, my name is Brian Colphage. This is the GoFundMe. I am a verified blue check Facebook page as a public figure, and I'm a Purple Heart recipient, triple amputee. So this guy thinks that him being a blue check mark Facebook page is more important than his Purple Heart. Or maybe that's just...
Well, he was doing that for his verification so the people would know that he's not... Yeah, it's not a scam. Which, like, that's fine. You know who the guy is. It's not really going to help you, because through that blue check mark, you're not going to find out where he lives.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure there are ways of doing it, and he can get doxxed if he does scam everybody.
Miriam, Florida? Miriam.
But honestly, Florida? Like, it. At the end of the day, though, if he gets, you know... Because he says he's going to refund everybody if he doesn't get, like, close to the number, which I guess you really need to define close to. But if he gets $10 million. So, yeah, he gets $10 million. He makes a private donation. He can donate $1 million.
And
that's still a significant donation, yeah, and now he's $9 million richer.
Which I don't think he would do, for the record. I don't know the man personally.
I don't think he would.
But in this public of a spotlight, like, he would be crucified for it.
How are they going to know?
How are they going
to
do it?
Well, they found that one couple that scammed the, quote, homeless guy.
Plus
that gave his last 20 and it was
no
a shame
guarantee
the whole time.
That donation to the government will go towards the wall.
Yeah, it could go toward anything.
Like, especially if he's just donating it straight to the Trump administration.
Uh-huh.
Like, it's going to his next
campaign.
I think
it's going to the Treasury, if I remember correctly. But Mandy's absolutely right. You were talking about the homeless guy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we talked about it. I think we talked about it on the show where... feel good story of the homeless guy gave this woman his last $20 to get her gas. It turns out it was a giant scam between the three, that the only reason they found out about it was because they took more money from the homeless guy than they agreed upon. And so it all came to light that
Which
it was a huge scam.
How fucking stupid are you?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Like, I guess they thought, oh, he's homeless. We can fucking do whatever we want to the guy. But yeah,
well,
they
was
all
he
got
actually
fucked.
Homeless?
He was. No,
part.
He was legit homeless.
Okay.
Yeah. He was legit homeless. They had met each other and just decided to pull the scam because he had done something similar years before. So, yeah, people are shitty. And I don't think this guy, Brian Kilfage or whatever is, I don't think he's scamming anybody. I think he truly believes that he can make a difference. Because there are people that believe the wall will make a difference, and I'm telling you that it won't. You ever heard of a plane?
No, shit. Yeah, I mean, like, all these undocumented immigrants, people talk about, like, people coming here illegally. You know how many of the undocumented immigrants came here illegally? It's a very small percentage. Most of them came over here completely legally, and they just stayed.
And I like how you motherfuckers are looking at, and they all say, well, I'm tired of illegals coming over here and killing people and causing crimes. Like, okay, the percentage of illegal immigrants that commit crimes versus the amount of people from America that fucking murder each other, rob each other, and you're complaining about them, you're saying it's okay when Americans murder Americans, but if some fucking wetback gets over here from across the way, I'm gonna fucking kill him myself.
You better
now, fuck that noise.
You better be quoting somebody, Bubba.
I'm quoting the idiots that would say it.
Okay, good.
Yeah, ooh. No, I.
Yeah, you put a big asterisk by that.
Oh, I think at this point people assume it. No, it just pisses me off. It just pisses me off that there is such a high crime rate in America that none of these people have ever cared about.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't affect them. But then you hear some asshole on TV that says Mexicans are the problem, which they're not. But you will donate money to that instead? That is so infuriating.
They also talk about, like, you know, the whole jobs thing is what really bothers me. Like, they've got, like, you know, immigrants are coming in here, legal immigrants are coming here and taking jobs from honest Americans.
Yeah.
They're not taking a job you want.
Yeah. Right?
That's how they're getting hired.
They're not taking, like, they're not working in labs and science, you know. They're working in fields. Uh-huh. They're working the dirty, hot jobs that your fat white ass ain't going to get out there and do.
You'd rather sit on unemployment.
So, like, being from Perryville, it's actually kind of like, people would say it's an issue, but it's really not. But, like, we have a high percentage of, like, Hispanic people that, like,
because they come in my store and don't communicate with me whatsoever because they want something because they can't speak English.
Yeah, and that's been a thing for
and it's infuriating because I want to be able to help them but I can't because of the language barrier.
Oh, good, I'm so happy you said it like that.
Yeah, I was getting worried. I'm like, where is this going?
No, I hate the fact when I have someone in my store that I can't help because I can't talk to them.
Yeah,
I mean, but like, because they're just assholes.
Yeah, well, like, I had to, like, whenever I worked at Subway there, I just learned how to say shit in Spanish just
to
help them out.
Yeah, you can have your phone now, right? Like, on the floor. Google Translate.
That shit
actually, it works really well.
Okay. He's right, but it's just so awkward. You listen to them and go, hold on.
No, yeah, basically, you pull it out. You have them talk into it. It translates it to English.
As best it can.
As best it can, which will get the general point across.
Yeah.
Then you do the same thing, and it'll do it in Spanish. Like, you know, I've actually seen kids have conversations with Google Translate. It's really neat.
I just have a feeling Lindsay's going to pull a Peggy Hill and tell the guy that she's got a lot of good anuses.
He's
a very honorable
horse. Google Translate will write out the Spanish and also say it if you need it to.
But yeah, no, back to like the main part of it. Like, people are super shitty to them.
Yeah.
And they're just like, they're taking our jobs. But like, they're working at TG and Gilster's in the factories. The jobs that you literally shit on.
Yeah.
So that I've heard people shit on.
Uh-huh.
And then other people talk about they do it, you know, for below minimum wage. They don't.
No.
Like, most of the time, they are working like minimum wage to sometimes, like, I've heard $10 an hour in those factory jobs. Like,
they get
paid.
Oh, wait.
That'll piss people off more.
Or, yeah. Like, yeah. They'll work for.
You should know, though, factories are going to make at least that.
Right. Yeah. No, like, the fact they make what a regular person would make in, like, a legal citizen, I guess I should say, not a regular person. That was a terrible way of putting that.
Yeah, we know what you mean.
Yeah. A legal citizen would make the same amount these guys are, but legal citizens don't want to work these jobs because, in fairness, they are shitty, shitty jobs.
When I dated Vina and I worked on her farm, her family's farm, for a week because I guess it was a way to introduce me to the family. They had all migrant workers, and it was like, I remember saying, like, why do you guys don't hire like anyone other than migrant workers? They're like, well, they don't work as hard. I was like, oh, touche. Yeah.
And or they just don't want to do it.
Yeah, yeah. And you got people like Tucker Carlson going on Fox News saying that immigration makes the country dirtier.
Hello, our country was formed on immigration.
Yeah, it's funny how what a fucking stance we've taken in the past couple of years of, like, we don't want other people coming over here. We got it now. Fuck them. This is a white Christian country.
Oh, yeah, cultural appropriation and all this other stuff. Like, they're taking away my white culture.
Look, sir, I come from white people, and I'm perfectly fine with it. Like, I always thought America was a melting pot. It's where all races, religions come together and have freedom. That's what we base the fucking country on.
And we have a lot of motherfuckers trying to pour bleach in it right now.
We are. Well, you know what bleach is.
And bleach kills everything.
Yeah.
It's
fucking white people have tried their best over the years.
I think we talked about this before the show yesterday with Asa. I saw someone had a shirt it was a black dude had a shirt with a picture of a bottle of bleach on it, Clorox. And it said, it's like the police. It's great for whites, but destroys colors.
Oh.
Which broke me.
Fuck, that's awesome.
Did you drop your...
I dropped my eraser.
God, worst child. Day ever.
Thank you.
All right, so that's our political high horse for the night.
Yeah, I know it was going to be Square Enix, and I was just going to be a shitty human for, like, bitching at this company.
Wait,
and
to be fair, like, we're not even going to touch Syria. So,
no, yeah, that's a shit show and a half.
They're pulling
right
out
there.
Of Syria, pulling the troops out.
Oh.
Yeah. Even Republicans are like, that's a bad idea.
Yeah, everybody's like, that's a bad idea, but Trump's like, we've got to help out Putin.
Putin thinks it's a great idea.
Mm. Giving Putin that win in Syria.
Oh,
Putin on the Ritz.
But anyway.
World War III is on the brink.
Yeah, no, Trump
Why
had to make Papa Putin
happy.
Why would
you call it World War I?
Three.
Do you think there's going to be a second World War?
Called it.
That was the Great War at the time.
That became World War One.
Yeah, it was later referred to.
No war is great, Jesse.
Nah.
I'm a pacifist myself. I really am.
But it was the Great War.
That was okay.
Jeremy called it the Great War.
To me, the Great War was, oh God, you have to dig way into the history books. This was in a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away.
Was it in the future?
Did it take place among the stars?
It was the Clone Wars. Oh, those were rough.
That was a rough war.
Many a robot died that day, I'll tell you.
Wait.
Roger, roger.
All right. Roger, roger.
Oh, no.
Let's stop offending people and let's talk about our favorites from 2018. Obviously, since Nerd Up is on Sunday, are you guys going to do this too, or are we going to do it tonight and you're going to just do regular news?
It'll be regular news because we got like some trailers to talk about. Like, there's some big news happening.
I want to talk about those trailers too right now.
Men in Black?
Men in Black and Hellboy.
I haven't seen the Men in Black one.
The Men in Black one looks really good.
Yeah, it does.
Except for the song.
You showed me Hellboy.
Well, it just came out today, Men in Black.
Okay, well. Yep.
It reunites, is it Tessa Thompson?
Tessa Thompson and Chris Hemsworth.
From Thor.
Yep. Okay.
Valkyrie and Thor. Hey, did you see the little scene at the end where he throws the hammer at him?
Yeah.
That made me laugh quite a bit.
That was pretty funny. Yeah. He's like, what an excellent catch.
Yeah. So it looks really good. Liam Neeson's in it.
Yes.
Other people probably.
Sure.
Yeah.
No one cares.
Does it matter now?
No, but it is a direct continuation. This was the movie that was supposed to be the 21 Jump Street crossover. And then they cut out 21 Jump Street. You knew about that, right?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, they were making a 21 Jump Street Men in Black crossover movie.
And I vaguely remember you saying something.
And they
thought,
you know, that's probably a bad idea.
And it was.
It was.
And I'm glad that never saw the light of day.
Yeah. So instead, we got Men in Black International. It's set in London, where Liam Neeson is the head of the London branch of the MIB, which is great.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it looks like a lot of fun. Hellboy also looked like a lot of fun.
Yes, it does.
Yeah. Although, I agree with what a lot of people said. With that much makeup on, just got Ron Perlman back.
Seriously.
Like, what does the fucking matter?
I mean, David Harbour still does a fine job so far for like he was,
but I don't want to be that guy that's like, no, that's not my Hellboy. Because he looks really good in it. But Ron Perlman was such a good Hellboy.
Yeah, Ron Perlman had the voice down.
Yeah.
And yeah, like David Harbour does great. Like, and I need to see more of him before I make any more comments about him. Yeah. No, that too.
I guess I'm a little sad because this movie does not include Liz Sherman or Abe Sapien at all.
No.
Which kind of depresses me because I really like them.
I mean, I'm going to guess they're going to get introduced in further installments.
But it does have, what is his name? Lobster, fuck, what is his name?
I do not know. I think it's Lobster Jones. I know very little about the Hellboy universe, especially
Lobster Johnson.
Lobster Johnson.
Guess what he looks like?
A lobster?
No, he's just a guy in a like a cowl. It's who plays him that really has me excited. Thomas Hayden Church.
Okay.
Neat.
Love Thomas Hayden Church. He was on Wings.
It's a name I haven't heard in a long time.
The last time I heard about Thomas Hayden Church was Spider-Man 3, honestly.
What was he in Spider-Man
3? He was Sandman.
Fuck, yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
All right.
It's Garrett's car.
So what happened to him?
Dead air here.
I just
is
saw
he okay?
Picture. Yeah, no, he's fine.
His car is fucked.
It's my tag team partner in Illinois.
Damn.
Yeah, you haven't met him.
What happened?
Dexter.
Yeah, I know who he is.
I guess he got hit from the side. Yeah, no, he's okay.
He got T-boned.
Because like he messaged like
his car got T-boned.
He said he wasn't gonna be at practice, and then he texted me. He's like, "Yeah, my day was worse than yours." And I was like, "What happened? If your day was worse than mine?" And then he told me to check Facebook, and that's what I saw.
Aww.
Yeah. He's okay. He said his wrist hurts. He's like, I'll wake up in the morning, and I bet it's going to suck. And I was like, well.
Probably. Well, I'm glad he's okay.
Yeah, we also want to send a shout-out to Austin Lane, who had a surgery today.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, apparently it went well.
Yeah, 2 hours. 2 hour surgery.
Oh, God. Did they build him a new shoulder?
Yeah.
Oh, that's scary.
It's made out of Gundanium.
No. he
adamantium.
Doesn't know what that is.
You know what Gundanium is, don't you?
No. Is it Futurama again?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
You idiot.
It's not Futurama, Dalton.
Let's start.
No, fuck you guys. What is it?
Let's see. What metal could be made from Gundanium?
Oh, is it Gundam?
Uh-huh.
There you go, buddy.
I'm good at making porn parodies of the titles. That's all I'm really good at.
It's true. He was popping them off last night.
I listened to that on the pre-show. That was pretty funny.
That was a lot of fun. Let's start off by talking about our favorite music of the year, because that'll get Mandy back into it.
Sure.
Briefly.
Well, let me know when you're done, because the only new music I listen to is what you play.
Okay, then. This should be easy. We'll start with Mandy. Mandy, what was your favorite album of the year?
Coheed.
Jesse, what's your favorite album of the year?
And John Bellion.
I was actually kind of surprised that Mandy hit us with Coheed for our favorite album of the year. Unheavenly Creatures for sure.
I second that. Or third that. Dalton?
I'm actually going to go with Cool Patrol by Ninja Sex Party. I loved that album.
That came out this year?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Huh. A lot of the songs came out last year, but the full album came out this year.
I'm going to look it up.
I know Twerp would also, if we were doing a top five, Twerp would have made my list as well. And Muse's new album was really good.
I haven't heard any of Muse's new album yet.
It was fantastic. I really, really liked
it. Did you say it's Cool Party or
Ninja's Cool Patrol.
Cool Patrol.
Yeah.
From Ninja Sex Party.
That's the guys from Ego Raptor, right?
The Game Grumps. One of the guys from Game Grumps.
Yeah. Danny Sexbang from Game Grumps. And then Ninja Brian make up Ninja Sex Party.
Do you know his name isn't actually even Ninja?
Shit.
And yeah, Dalton wins because that was in 2018.
I knew. I was aware.
Twerp also released an album.
They're a musical comedy duo. So they're kind of like Lil Dicky. Dicky Roberts. What is his name?
Lil Dicky.
Lil Dicky. Or he's not a real rapper. He's a comedy act that raps.
No. Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Lil Dicky is a rapper.
He raps about his dick.
Every rapper raps about their dick. No, he's just the only one that doesn't about
his doing a bit from the music video, buddy. It's from the Freaky Friday video.
How his ball stand up on his dick?
How's his dick stand up?
He's like Lonely Island. They're pretty much the exact same.
We had a like 20-minute argument about this one day.
Years ago.
It was last year, I'm pretty sure.
Because Dalton, for some reason, thinks there's a distinction between the Lonely Island and Lil Dicky.
They're very much.
And I would like to know what that distinction is.
As far as genre, they're definitely in the same genre.
They're both comedy rappers.
Yeah. Do you have an argument to that, Dalton?
They both worked with legit rap artists. Lonely Island worked with Twista. Was it E-40? I forget.
They also worked with, E-40, but not Twista.
I don't know who any of these
Lonely
are.
Island was never on, like, never considered. They're not considered actual rappers, whereas Lil Dicky has, like, been.
They released an album.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I've heard Lonely Island on the radio. I've never heard Lil Dicky on the album on the radio.
It's because his music's too fly for the radio.
Is it?
Yeah. You're going to play a 9-minute song on the radio? You got to play a commercial sometime.
They could condense it.
No, you miss so much if you do.
I'm sorry. I mean, did you never hear
the song?
He has
more than a few songs that would be short. Like Freaky Friday could easily be on the radio.
Well, they didn't say the N word so much.
I mean, like that's on the radio.
Because I'm that.
Big ups, my.
You can't even do that, the pussy ass one, because that's you can't say either of those names.
I can't even do that. Because
I'm that, and then yeah, it goes back into the original joke.
And I'm that beep.
No, bleep it. That makes it substantially funnier. That song also came out this year.
I don't know why Shannon's laughing. Too much Lil Dicky.
He's really hoping one of us slip up in the middle of doing.
I'll say the N word. I've said it so many times, and I've never gotten. Well, I got one guy. He quit the show because of it. But
that's accurate.
Other than that, but you know what was funny about that was that it wasn't even. I have never said the N word on this show to say the N word. I've said it in context of what someone else was saying.
It's true.
And apparently, the word itself, you know, whatever. It's fine. I'm an entertainer. It's what I do. I offend. Lindsay, what was your favorite album this year?
I don't know, because I don't listen to new stuff.
It could be a soundtrack.
I haven't really listened to any new soundtracks this year.
Okay, well, what did you listen to the most this year? Pretend it doesn't have to be new. What did you listen to the most this year?
I mean, I just listen to the same old stupid crap I always listen to.
Define it. Give examples.
My stupid anime theme song music.
Name one, for the love of God.
I want to. Just move on.
No, we're not moving on. We're stopping right here until you say something.
Well, it's going to be a long show.
Name one fucking song you've listened to this year that you enjoyed.
Was it Weezer that remade Africa?
That was this year.
They did.
Okay.
That happened this year.
There you go.
I liked that.
You got it. All right.
This is America also came out this
year.
I forgot
pulling teeth.
Yep.
Is this America?
He still hasn't released an album after that, has he?
I don't think he's going to. I think he just released that song.
If Ali were here, she would for sure say that 21 Pilots. Was it called Vulture?
Maybe.
Something Wings.
Like that. Kohi came out way too close to it. And maybe
same completely. Day.
Literally the same day.
Same
oh,
day.
Yeah. Yeah, no. And it made me forget that they had an album.
Which really makes sense, because that 21 Pilots album is also really good.
Like, I listened to it like a couple of nights later, like after I had listened to the Kohi album like at least 4 times. Then I checked out the 21 Pilots album, and it was good. And then I went right back to Kohi.
Yeah.
I did the same thing with Muse, to be fair, and the new Disturbed album. Which was not very good.
It's hard not to just keep going back to Kohi because it's so good.
Accurate.
Like every when I first listened to it, there were like three or four songs that I thought, well, these aren't as good as the, you know, as the other ones that they put out. But as I listened to it over time, I came to appreciate them so much more. And it's like every song on that album is fire.
Yeah, no, I can listen to the entire album all the way through and enjoy every song now.
Over and over and over again. Then it makes me want to listen to other Coheed albums because I don't want to just listen to the same album over and over and over again.
That's what I do.
So I've gone back and listened to Keep It Secret to Silent Earth 3 and even, what was their first album?
Second Stage Turbine Blade.
Even the one that they did that wasn't
good, Apollo and Burning Star 4, I liked a whole lot.
I love that one.
Like, that's the one I still listen to.
Is that
to.
The one that has Welcome Home?
Yep.
I think it's Color Before the Sun. I think it's what it's called.
Yeah, Color Before. Yeah.
Yeah, Color Before the Sun.
Is that the one with Peace on the Mountain?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The one that's literally about Claudio Sanchez's life instead of his characters. Yeah. My God, they're such good artists. So, congratulations, Coheed and Cambria. You win Artist of the Year from
Podzilla. You got the Zilla Award.
We expect a phone call.
Claudio, please.
I'm pretty sure we're going to have to send something out for them to recognize us.
Oh, I'm pretty sure Claudio. Jesse knows him.
Oh.
I've met him.
Did you touch his hair?
I did.
I've seen the picture. Of them together,
it's on my Facebook.
It was his profile for literally the longest time, like 5 years.
He hasn't changed it for. You haven't changed it since the Paducah show.
That is correct.
Oh God,
that's not a great picture.
Wait a minute, no, that wasn't Paducah. That was
Papa Bluff.
Yeah. I've never been to Paducah.
Because I think you should put the Coheed picture back up. You know,
that's a really old picture now.
It doesn't matter.
Also, in fairness, this picture that you currently have is from 2016.
Yeah.
Holy shit!
I don't change my profile picture often.
It was the last time I didn't have a beard.
None of us change as much as you do, Shannon.
That's because I get bored. I get so bored, and I'm like,
I just changed mine.
I'm OCD.
I haven't changed it since like March.
Yeah, basically, if I find a picture of myself that I don't completely hate, that stays as my profile picture for a while. I'm a hard man to please when it comes to pictures of myself.
Well, have you ever noticed how many of my pictures aren't of me? It's fucking Puka right now.
Yeah, but I also don't want to be that
Merry
person
Christmas.
That does.
You want to be Kirk Waters?
Right.
God damn. His picture is of Sans Undertale fucking another character.
God damn.
Because Kirk Waters is weird.
He's a weird motherfucker.
I'm pretty sure I had to unfollow him.
I wanted to leave.
Nope, I'm definitely still followed to him. Why is he?
Because when I scroll it, I just go, what the fuck?
Oh, it's the fucking Inkling cover photo. Jesus! Make sure everybody sees it.
Yep.
I've talked to him. He definitely wants to make kids with a squid. What? Which one?
It's just a pile of condoms.
I had to take that one down.
Why really? The fuck is that Breaking Dalton?
Why did you have to take it down?
Well, I told Kirk to take it down.
Your best friend?
No. I'm not even friends with him on Facebook.
He's the only one at this table that's not.
I had to delete him.
You motherfucker.
Fending me way too
you
much.
You introduce us all to Kirk Waters, and then you're like, bye, you can deal with this shit.
I fucking bailed.
That's
you
fucking
rude.
Oh,
my fucking stomach hurts.
All right, let's move on to video games. This will perk Lindsay up.
Shit, I thought it was going to be Facebook fans. I was going to nominate Kirk Waters.
All right, who's your favorite Facebook friend?
Kirk Waters.
Unanimous. All right, yeah, video all games. Things. Mandy, what was your favorite video game 2018?
Pass. I can't choose yet.
Okay, Jesse, we'll start with you. Let's start with Lindsay because we all know she'll have the easy answer we'll have time to think.
Let's go Eevee.
There you go. Tell us why, though. What did you love about it?
Well, it's Pokemon.
It is.
And I finally get to play Pokemon on the big screen as opposed to the little screen, although I can do both.
And the graphics are way better than the old ones.
Yes, it's really pretty.
Now, did you
fun.
Have a problem with the way they changed the capture mechanics?
No, I don't think so. I mean, sometimes it's aggravating that the ball doesn't go the direction you're throwing.
That is extremely true.
But, yeah, like when you're clearly throwing forward and it goes to the left, like, what is happening here?
The Pokeball sometimes
goes kind of weird. Or when you're
clearly
trying to throw to the right and it goes to the left.
Or you throw it very softly and it launches backwards.
Yeah.
And I imagine what the other trainers are seeing. They're seeing you just throw balls ran like in opposite directions of where the Pokemon are.
And then suddenly they'll see you throw like this crazy ass looking fucking curveball that just goes all over the place and then nails them. Like, what the hell is this?
How'd you do that?
Truly the greatest trainer of all time. Well, I liked Let's Go Eevee, but I found it disappointing. Honestly, I like Let's Go Pikachu more. It was a superior game.
Pika's a diva.
I wanted Let's Go Eevee, but I got Let's Go Pikachu because my roommate got Let's Go Eevee, and I figure I will see him or Lindsay more often than anybody else.
Probably.
And can trade Pokemon if need be.
Yes.
So, yeah, I went with Let's Go Pikachu for that reason.
That's also got Let's Go Pikachu.
Plus, if you have it on your Switch, you should have got a thing in Smash Brothers.
I did.
Yeah.
A couple of spirits.
Not that they're great.
They are not.
But they're special.
Yes, they are.
Dalton, let's go counterclockwise. What do you got?
God of War. Jesus, why did you do that over mine? For those who didn't hear me, because Shan's being a fucking dick, it was God of War. God.
I'm done. I swear to God, I'm done.
God of War.
Okay.
It was after. It's fine.
Hey, Dalton.
Yeah. God. No, I'm not amused by it right now.
It's because I don't have the puppet. God damn, if you don't think Dolphin Anthony's coming back now that I'm a bad guy.
I swear to God, if you fucking
bring I'm bringing him to fucking Charleston.
Yes.
Yes.
It became so much funnier when I realized he was talking about wrestling.
So
I'm going to lose my license in Missouri because I will punch him in the face.
I'm going to tell everybody, like, I know you guys are getting tired of hearing me talk about Dalton, so I invited a friend, Dolphin Anthony, to talk to the crowd.
Hello, brother.
So do I need to make it glasses and a hat?
And a beard.
And a beard.
I will pay Justin.
Toss it to me if you need to get away from him. We can play monkey in the middle.
I will pay Justin $50 to take that off of you.
I mean, I got it for free, so it's not like... But I love that little dolphin.
I know.
Yeah.
I'm
about to say, if it's really worth $50 to you, I'll buy so many of them.
His actual name is Stanley.
I'll just hit Justin up. Like, you probably buy those things for like $5 a piece.
Like, they were like 15, it was 15 or 20 bucks at Hastings, but...
Because it was Archer. It's the Archer dolphin.
Right. But I'm sure I can find a Chinese knockoff. It doesn't have to be the fancy Archer one.
No, it's from a show over there called Arthur. It's similar.
Or, yeah, like, I mean, if Justin is the one taking, I can just hit Justin up, like, yeah, I bought this one on the internet and I gave it to Shannon. You better pay Justin again.
All right, Dalton, why'd you like God of War?
This is such a fun game. I was enthralled. I'm definitely not a person that can just sit through and play an entire game in, like, a short amount of time. But I was very much like God of War made me care about it that much, and the mechanics of it were really fun. The puzzles were great. You felt like Thor. Like, you've heard Asa say all this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you feel like Thor whenever you just call the axe back, and it doesn't matter where it's at. Even if you haven't played it with it for like 20 minutes, it goes. You just hear hand. It's fantastic. Boy's great.
It's also very bloody. Although not as bloody as the older ones.
It was toned down from the other games.
Yeah. I thought Triple H did a great job in the role, too.
I hate you.
Like, he was very convincing as...
You're such a piece of shit.
I know. I know, brother.
Why does Dolphin Anthony say brother so much?
Dolphin Anthony and Kirk Waters, that's the new tag team.
Oh, God.
Because
it's our fucking alter ego.
Because Dolphin loves being Waters, if you know what I mean. He takes the bat cave, if you know what I mean.
As dolphins are wont to do.
Yeah. Stick that nose up my ass. Jesse.
God damn it.
What's your favorite game of 2018?
There were a lot of games came out this year that were really good. I don't know. Probably Spider-Man for PlayStation 4. But, like, Celeste came out this year that was incredible. Super Smash Brothers came out this year that was incredible.
Super Smash Brothers, by the way, smashing records everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
It's the fastest selling Nintendo game in Europe's history. It's killing it in the United States. It is a hit everywhere. It's amazing.
It's so good. It's absolutely worth it. Like, it deserves every bit of that. And then
thank God they had the Game Awards before it came out.
Right?
Fuckers.
It would have taken everything. Black Ops 4. Ended up being really, really good. Like, the multiplayer was super fun.
It's pretty good.
It was a good year for video games, but yeah, probably Spider-Man for PS4 was my game of the year. The first game I have ever platinumed on PlayStation.
Did you see they released the Raimi outfit today?
I did. I still need to beat the DLC. I have it. I just haven't beaten it yet. Mostly because I haven't sat down and played a single player game since Spider-Man. Because I'm, as everyone knows about me, I don't do single-player games often.
Right.
I am far more likely to be sitting around playing a multiplayer game with friends than I am playing some single-player game.
Hold up in your room, not talking to people.
Oh, wait, that's
games.
Me.
No, that's Bob.
Yes.
I mean, if there are people Dr. to talk Bob? To, I'll come out. Unless I think they're having a conversation that I shouldn't be a part of.
Which they usually are.
That's accurate.
Mandy, all right, enough stalling.
I honestly don't play much. Like, I still play Overwatch, and I'm playing the Kingdom Hearts games because Kingdom Hearts is going to be the best game for the next, like, 5 years. So...
You hope?
I know. I guess Smash Brothers and Call of Duty because they're, like, the only ones I'm playing that aren't one of those games. So...
By that. They're both really, really good.
Yeah, I mean, Smash Brothers is a solid pick for Game of the Year, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah. My favorite game, it was a big year for games for me too, and I honestly would almost put Fallout 76 at my top just to flip off everybody.
Be a hot take there to get some clicks and some comments.
I super enjoyed Fallout 76. I don't care what anyone says. Like, I played that. And the only reason I stopped playing it is because we started playing Red Dead Online. Like, because Bob wanted to play that. If Dalton wanted to play, like, Fallout 76 more, I would probably keep playing it. But I'm taking a sabbatical while I play Red Dead. Red Dead would have also been at the top of my list, but I didn't play the single player a lot. It was really good, but I'm more interested in the multiplayer, and the multiplayer's fun, but it's kind of bare bones right now. There's not a ton to do. Mm-hmm. So, and Smash Brothers, you guys have already mentioned, so I'm going to throw a hot take at you. My game of the year, the game that probably made me smile the most, Octopath Traveler on the Nintendo Switch.
It's a good game.
If you asked me what the prettiest game of the year was, I would say Octopath Traveler.
Which is great because it's
still Spider-Man.
Well, I mean, it's Spider-Man is definitely better looking, but it's the art style of Octopath that really sets it apart.
It's it's genuinely beautiful.
Yeah, the art style is really, really good in Octopath. I'm not trying to take anything away from it, but
I love the storyline.
My God, Spider-Man was pretty.
I just think I really want to keep playing Octopath because I haven't beat it, but I truly thought Octopath was just an enchanting experience for me. And there's a lot of great games that came out this year. My wallet was screaming. Soul Calibur 6 came out. No, you're not a big Soul Calibur. You're a Soul Calibur fan,
I love Soul Calibur, but like, I wasn't going to buy that game, and you guys didn't seem that interested in playing it while we were here. So
I love playing it, but again, this past 3-4 months, it's been hit,
been bam,
after,
bam,
hit
bam.
After hit. Yeah, it's hard to keep your head above water at this point.
Another one.
It's been a while since like I've had like so many games that I've purchased, because I also bought Diablo 3 on the Switch.
Same.
Which means that's the sixth time I've bought that game.
It's bad when you have to keep counting.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I mean, if you want to count expansion packs, fucking.
Especially if you count expansion packs.
World of Warcraft came out with their newest expansion pack. Fuck, what
we
was it called?
We couldn't play the first day because it crashed.
Called Who Gives a Fuck?
What the?
The look that I just got
Battle
from Kirk.
For Azeroth.
I mean, Shannon.
Battle for Azeroth, yeah.
I gave them time to think of it.
I didn't even look it up. Are you proud of me for once?
I'm proud of you, Dad. You finally put down the bottle. Now, if you and Mom can just reconcile, then maybe Sis can come home and she doesn't have to go live with Uncle Touchy anymore.
Uncle Touchy.
I didn't know where this was going, but I ended up enjoying the trip.
Thank you.
She didn't.
Yeah.
It's that moment. Lindsay and I are on the same brainwave, but I'm kind of afraid.
Well, that's scary. Yeah. We're all afraid of that. All right. Favorite movie of 2018?
That's a much harder topic.
Yes. Let's start, we did with Lindsay last time. Let's start with Lindsay again.
I mean, oh, that's fine. Christopher Robin.
I knew you were going to say Christopher Robin.
I have that on my
list. I cried, but it was so good.
It was so nostalgic.
I'm fine with crying to it.
What's really funny is that IGN shit all over that movie.
Why?
Yeah, they gave it like a 4.
Vanity Fair, I think, is saying that Jim Cummings deserves an Oscar nomination for it.
For Pooh?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Because they said because there's an Oscar-worthy performance, and it's not Ewan McGregor. And
he was good, too.
I would love to see Jim Cummings get one for it.
As who?
That would be sweet.
For Pooh or Tigger. He did both.
Tigger. Is that a cross between Tiger and... Or are you just a big old fan of Winnie the Pooh?
Why he didn't have black stripes, though, and eyebrows.
Who?
I still haven't seen it.
Tigger.
I have.
Have you guys not seen it?
It's scary. I can't.
It's so good.
That fucking bear is creepy.
No, he is adorable. My God, he's the cutest thing.
But
like, I can't. I'm not watching Detective Pikachu.
There's a part in the movie. I won't say what happens. Where Ewan McGregor's character, Christopher Robin's, walking up to Pooh as he's sitting there looking out like over the fucking hills and stuff. And as soon as I see him walking toward him, I'm like, oh no, and tears just start forming. I'm like, please don't. I don't care what happens, but don't do it.
Dude, I was such a huge Winnie the Pooh fan, like so much as a child. So
same.
I was like, oh my gosh.
No,
so
like I was terrified when I heard they were doing it, but as soon as I heard that they got Jim involved again, I'm like, nope, I'm good.
It
was genuinely sweet. Mm-hmm. Like it's
it.
Yeah, you'd have to be a cold-hearted bastard.
And
not
I'm not
to
saying it's a bad movie. Like I'm not.
You're just creeped out by the puppet.
I'm creeped out by the characters. Yeah.
Why?
And also, like, I was
it's
never
just
a big,
silly old Pooh Bear.
They're so fluffy.
I was never a big Winnie the Pooh fan, and then also then playing Kingdom Hearts like also made me hate Winnie the Pooh.
Man, you would have hated the. Did I ever tell you guys about like the Winnie the Pooh doll we had when I was a kid?
Yes. That the batteries would like start to go out and get all demonic.
Yeah. No, it would do
some
like
some batteries.
Please change my batteries, and then the other one
and then
like
it would start giggling.
Oh, well, bother!
Then it would start doing its voice lines, but in the same way, like please play with me, and it's like oh god.
Lindsay, I'm really surprised you didn't pick Ready Player One.
I forgot about it.
Because
did that
you
release this year?
Yeah.
Oh no, there were so like no, I was totally geeking out on it, and like when they were going through other stuff, I'm like, there better be a Gundam in here.
Oh yeah, I don't think I've ever seen Lindsay as happy watching a movie as I saw her watching Ready Player One.
It was really, really good.
They had the Iron Giant and Akira's motorcycle,
and he fought the Gundam.
Yes.
Is what it did.
It's true. That happened.
Favorite movie of the year.
Ralph Breaks the Internet.
Ooh, I liked that one,
that
too.
That one was really good.
He wrecked it.
I haven't seen it yet.
Like, I don't like picking Marvel.
You haven't seen it?
Aw, so I don't good. Like picking, like, Marvel movies for this because, like, that's kind of the cop-out answer. I genuinely loved Ralph Breaks the Internet. I thought that movie was full of... It's like the first one. It was full of charm. Fucking made me cry at the end.
Yep.
That fucking got me. She didn't see me. It's fine.
I really want to see it.
Oh, it's great. I suggest it. It's like... If you were just like, favorite superhero movie, that would be different. But like, Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Well, did we only have one superhero movie come out this year?
Two.
No, we had three.
Oh, don't tell me. Venom.
Oh, Aquaman.
Four. Five.
Okay, hold on. Please.
Shit.
For the love of God, let me guess. Venom, Infinity War, that's it. What are the others?
Black Panther.
Ant-Man and the
Shit,
Wasp.
Was that this year?
Yeah, that was at the beginning of the year.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, that was me.
That's what I said. I don't remember much of this year because so much has happened.
It's a fantastic movie, Black Panther.
Black Panther's an incredible one.
Haven't seen Ant-Man and the Wasp yet.
The Incredibles 2. Awesome.
I own it.
A superhero movie.
Incredibles 2 did come out.
It's a superhero movie.
I still haven't watched that one.
Oh, it's so good.
I own it. That's another movie I own that I haven't seen.
Deadpool 2 came out this year.
No.
Deadpool 2 came out this year, too?
Yeah.
Was that this year?
Seven. Seven
Holy
superhero
shit.
Movies this year.
Although I will be honest, I was still disappointed by Deadpool 2. I liked it, but it wasn't as good as
I loved
it.
The first one was funnier.
Well, they killed fucking Shatterstar, and I'll never forgive that.
Spoilers? Yeah. It's not even been out for a year.
If the spoiler for the movie is a 3-second part that he gets, then you know the movie's got problems.
Because the
they also killed Black Tom Cassidy.
They did. Black Tom, you racist. It's such a layup joke, but whatever.
They also shove things up Juggernaut's asshole. That's not cool.
That was funny.
Poor Juggernaut. Poor. Jesse, what's your movie of the year?
Man, this is really, really hard to pick. There were so many good movies. Creed 2 was incredible.
Still haven't seen it.
Ralph Breaks the Internet was great. Incredibles 2 was great. Obviously, all three of those Marvel movies were just fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there were so many.
I'm trying to remember what else came out this year.
So many things. So many. Well, we were watching movies like
every weekend
there for a while.
I
yeah.
know, yeah. yeah.
Quiet Place came out this year. Really, really good.
It was good.
Hereditary came out, which was really, really good.
I still need to see Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah, I've heard that's fantastic.
Bohemian Rhapsody came out.
Still
Fantastic
see
Beast,
that.
The sequel came out. The Grinch came out, which
that was pretty good.
It was
I've
good.
Heard it was all right.
But Jesse, none of this is you picking a movie.
Oh no, I can't.
Jesse, I'm gonna need you to pick a film.
Until I started listing those movies, all of those were my pick.
But you haven't seen them. You have to, just one
yeah,
that
no,
you've
the,
seen.
The ones that I haven't seen, like that I mentioned, like those aren't in my picks. The ones that I mentioned at the beginning,
those
are my picks.
Okay, so the Marvel films as a whole.
Well, I mean, the Marvel movies, Fantastic Beasts.
Okay, so just stop.
Yeah, no, Creed 2.
He's
all...
failed this. Mandy, redeem it.
We already did Avengers and Chris Robin, so I very much enjoyed Solo.
I forgot about Solo.
I forgot about Solo, too.
I really like
that.
That
was probably on page 2.
I also,
seriously. 5.
I also really
like
Solo.
I can't remember a whole lot more. I mean, Incredibles 2 we mentioned, which was awesome. I don't watch movies as much as you guys, so.
But Solo was so much fun.
I think that's part of our problem is we watch too many movies.
Like, Solo was one of those movies that I was so sad that it got bad. Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Which I don't know how it did. It was so fucking
because it wasn't Harrison Ford.
It was also a bad release window.
Yeah.
Like, they've released every other one in, you know, December, and it's worked out. But this year, for whatever reason, they're like, February.
It's because they had Ralph.
That's probably.
When they're because next year it'll be Frozen.
But, I mean, my God. I don't know the guy that played Han Solo. I can never remember his name, but he did a great job. But fucking Donald Glover as Lando Calrissian was, like, slipping a foot into a fucking... comfortable thing you wear. Fuck, help me.
Shoe?
Old shoe?
No.
Slipper?
Slipper, the fancy ones.
House shoes.
House shoe, whatever. Donald Glover was amazing as Lando Calrissian.
He really was.
I'm to say. He out Billy D. Williamed Billy D. Williams.
I was about to say, are you saying that like that was a tough pair of shoes to fill, and he did it magnificently?
Yes.
He fit it like butter to a cheeseburger.
What the fuck?
Like okay, you've never, Minico.
Like you've never had a butter burger.
I have had a butter burger.
Exactly.
What about a hot dog pie?
Oh.
God damn it.
Oh.
I will draw a dick on your face right now, knowing you have to go
to
your job tomorrow.
All right, listen here, fuckers. I don't ever try to cause physical torment on you.
Okay, anyway.
Bringing up hot dog pie brings physical torment on me because it makes me want to retch.
That's mental.
Meet your maker.
So, by the way, yeah, no, Solo was a really good movie, and that was a great pick, Mandy.
Yes.
Thanks.
What's yours?
it was a really hard. I'm not going to do it. No, I'm kidding. I had two that I really liked in a year full of really great movies. I want to give an honorable mention to the movie Searching, which I thought was fantastic. It was the John Cho movie where his daughter goes missing, and it's all done in real time. Like, remember Unfriended?
Yeah.
It's all done like through Messenger and stuff of him trying to figure out what happened to his daughter.
I guess I didn't watch this one.
That's the one that Allie and I saw in St. Louis. Remember I texted you and said, do you have an interest in this? And you said no, so we went
watch it. Because I didn't know what it was. Yeah, that's fine.
But it's a great movie. Like, I highly recommend it.
Speaking of Unfriended, movie that is not worth anybody's top list.
Truth or Dare?
Unfriended Dark Web.
Oh, okay. And Truth or Dare.
And Truth or Dare. Yeah, that one
Truth
too.
Or Dare. IGN rated Truth or Dare higher than Christopher Robin.
What
the fuck?
I bet Jurassic World was good. I didn't get to see that yet.
Oh, that was also.
It was pretty good. It was pretty good.
I enjoyed that quite a bit.
What was my little dinosaur I liked? I forget his name.
Sticky.
Yes.
Oh, I like the Maze Runner. They finished that series this year. That was
Jesus
good.
Christ.
But my favorite movie, I haven't got to that part yet.
Sorry.
Was Overlord. I loved Overlord so much.
The military one.
Call of Duty Zombies, the movie. Yeah.
I was at work. When
like
we
it was. It
that.
Wasn't even the greatest movie, but it was just so much fun.
Or did I just not go because I didn't want to get out of bed?
You just didn't want to see it. Because I asked you, and you were like, I have no interest in seeing it. So we went, okay. So me and Bob and Allie went and watched it instead.
I don't remember.
Yeah. That was one of the two movies this year that you just declined, the other one being Hereditary.
Yeah.
I really like Tag.
Oh, Tag? Did that come out this year?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was great.
I thought it was hilarious. Also, I was drinking during it, so the part where... He's like, how many glasses of wine do you have? And he goes, how many arms does an octopus have? I lost my shit for like 10 minutes. Justin just staring, and I'm just like,
the man is just fucking dying.
He's fucking dying. Because he's like straight face, how many arms does an octopus have?
Hannibal Buress. Like, that
who
man
is just fantastic.
That man
anyway.
Can deliver a
so
line.
Like, fucking fantastic.
This year also had my most disappointing movie in a long time.
That.
The Predator.
Yeah.
I still haven't seen it because I heard it was so bad.
Yeah. I wanted to love it, and I couldn't.
I forgot Blockers came out this year. Fucking loved that movie.
I haven't seen that one.
I haven't either.
Oh, it's dumb, but it's funny.
Fucking Halloween was great.
Yeah, it was.
Halloween was amazing.
Did it come out this year?
No, that was last year. Which we should have the second part next year.
Venom, if Aaron Brooks is listening, Venom was really good, too. I liked Venom. Like, I know it wasn't a fantastic movie, but I liked it.
It was all right. Like, it was a solid popcorn flick. I liked it more than I did Justice League or Batman v Superman.
I did not, but I did like. Oh, you're gonna crucify me. I liked it more than Spider-Man Homecoming.
What the fuck?
Spider-Man.
Well, I'm sorry, you like bad movies.
Spider-Man Homecoming had one thing that will always put it above it, and that's Michael
Keaton
as the Vulture. But I just thought Venom was a fun movie, and Venom was cool to see. You know, Spider-Man was just. I don't know. It was too formula. I don't know.
It was too good.
Your Spider-Man had too much of a plot. He wanted popcorn action.
Venom had a plot.
Did it?
Alien crashes down. Alien gets loose. Becomes Venom.
I didn't even look at you that time, and I hadn't even seen that movie. I know that there's no plot in that fucking movie. I saw the trailers, and I could tell there wasn't a fucking
Listen
plot
Listen to
in that
this
movie.
Motherfucker over here. I hadn't even seen it, but I know it's terrible.
Justin
what,
liked
Mandy?
It.
You're the worst
I said,
part
I
of the internet.
I watched a lot of it. We had to stop because his mom came over to hang out, and then I had to go pick Mike up, so I didn't get to finish it.
No, you're
for
the
some
part
reason,
of the
I thought you were about to say we had to stop because we needed a Dieter.
No, not this time. Not this
also,
time.
Also, one
I don't want to hear it.
No, wait a minute. I'm the worst part of the internet?
You're the worst part of the internet.
Didn't
I You was, and the people that voted for that wall, you guys are side by side.
Was I going to use a racial slur earlier in the show?
I think you were.
No, I'm pretty sure that was you.
If I remember correctly, you said something about Mexican people.
Speaking of your friend Chad, go back to our Thanksgiving episode a couple years back.
Yes, go back to the episode where I molested my roommate Bob anally.
Over
and over and over again.
The running joke through the night.
As he was running through Bob.
Also, A Star Is Born came out, but I didn't get to see it.
No,
it's been remade like 8 times.
Yeah, but they said this one's the best version. And I have grown to I love Lady Gaga. I've changed my mind on her again.
I like Lady Gaga.
Streisand. If you're watching A Star Is Born, you watch Barbara Streisand.
I would watch Barbara Streisand walk off a cliff. That's what I'll watch her in. More
There's
like a Star Is Bored.
With Jack Black that I want to watch. The house with the clocks on the wall. Or
oh, yeah. That actually looked kind of cool,
it.
Too.
And I really want to watch it.
That just reminds me of that.
I think it's a really long movie, and that's why we haven't yet.
That just reminds me of the skit from SNL with Liev Schreiber. Dave's outside of the women's bathroom. And the woman comes to the bathroom, and he's like, hey, I'm Dave. What are you doing? I'm outside of the women's bathroom. Hey, have you seen that movie Clock in the House with the Clock in the Walls? That's not based on a true story, is it? And she just walks off.
Hello, Leaf Driver. I still haven't seen any of those stand-up or any of those SNL
bits.
It's
105 minutes. I guess it's not as long as I thought it was.
Nope, that ain't long at all.
I guess there was one movie we were going to watch. It was almost 3 hours. And I was like,
so most movies
anymore?
It's
like 11 o'clock. I'm not going
to
make it.
But once again, movie of the year has to go to, for the 30th year in a row, Tombstone. God every year it wins the title.
I can stand by that.
Yeah.
Super Mario.
It's a classic.
You know, Tombstone is a phenomenal
Tombstone
film.
Is still the best movie. I think I may now rank Tombstone up there with Ghostbusters. It's scary. It's like the Ghostbusters, they're holding on, but then fucking Kurt Russell and Val Kilmer and Sam Elliott sneak up with those mustaches.
Uh-huh. He's about to turn his head into a canoe.
Woo, boy. If that movie didn't fall apart in like the last kind of 10, 15 minutes and just kind of... The last 10 minutes of Tombstone is not as good as the first hour or 2 hours. Like, once they kill Johnny Ringo, it's like, once they kill Curly Bill, it kind of just, that should have been the end, the Curly Bill part. But whatever, it's still a great movie.
They wanted to wrap everything else up and give you a nice, happy package. Ending, which was unnecessary, in my opinion.
Yeah. Second place goes to Ghostbusters.
The 2016 one, right?
Right, of course.
I don't know. There was, I think I set a record for the most amount or most films I watched in theaters this year.
Yeah, there was a lot.
We went and saw a lot.
I had to start doing like the fucking Saturday and Sunday morning, like 10 a.m. just so I could afford it.
That's the only time we went to go see movies because that's,
for the most $6. Part, we went to a few that weren't, but yeah, most of
Thursday
them,
nights for me.
We almost watched Into the Spider-Verse on Sunday, but the only showing that was before 11 was the super screen one, and it was still $8.50. Yeah, and that for three people.
There's one at 9:55 tonight, and I'm just like, I can swing it.
The Spider-Verse?
Yeah, because it'd
don't
be six.
To work tomorrow?
It's
he's crazy.
It's a condensed day.
No, fair enough.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I'm seeing it this weekend.
I've heard it's amazing.
I have too.
I'm not seeing Squat until after Christmas.
You could though.
No, I can't.
You can see so
much because I have to be at work at 7 a.m. on Sunday.
Doesn't mean
and
you can't.
I don't get to leave until 9, and then I have to be back at 7 a.m. again on Monday.
Movies play throughout the day.
So yes, but I'd like to sleep and eat dinner. Thank you.
Says the woman that says that, and then for 2 hours sits in her fucking bed reading comics.
That's because I can't go to bed because my stupid brain won't let
me. We're downstairs. We're playing games or something, and she's like, oh, I'm going to bed. And then I'll go in there an hour later, say goodnight to her. She's just reading comics. An hour later, she's reading comics. I hear her. I'm downstairs, 2 a.m. playing Red Dead with Bob. I finally hear her go to the bathroom to go to sleep. And I'm like, are you fucking kidding me?
The joke
I don't want to hear you complain anymore.
So the joke I was going to make is 7 to 9 doesn't sound like that bad of a shift.
7 a.m. to 9 p.m.
I knew what you meant, but it was the joke that was in my head.
I don't know why you would have wanted to make that joke. Had you made it in the moment, she likely would have taken your head off.
That's
fine. She's not in a good mood already.
The marker would have been the least of your worries.
Because I close Saturday, all day Sunday, all day Monday, and then I get to be back at open the day after Christmas. Fuck retail.
Didn't you write your schedule?
It was dictated to me. I did indeed write it, but mine was dictated to
Please,
me.
Please, Lindsay, calm down. You're getting so legitimately angry. Oh, my God. She's furious.
I spittled on Jesse.
So just freaking make me cry and it won't matter.
Wait, you what?
Nothing.
Did you say you were crying?
About Voltron.
What Jesse the fuck? Why did we jump on that?
Jesse won't watch it so she can rant to
is
him.
She even, is Jesse even wearing green socks?
She was ranting to me yesterday. I just let her go. I was kept asking questions to let her get it off her chest. I was like, poor Lindsay right now. Talk to me.
I need to finish it. I really do. Like I've watched, I think, the first 4 episodes. And I absolutely loved the first episode.
Yes, it was great.
Everything about that episode made me happy.
Because they basically made the original Voltron cartoon canon into the show.
Yeah, she was telling me about that.
That was fantastic. Because
Pidge dresses as Pidge.
Yes.
Yep. Yeah. And then there's a bit with two characters that I really, really like had a thing, and I really liked that. And yeah, no, I was very happy with the first episode.
Is that a spoiler?
Yeah.
No. Okay.
Yay.
Yeah. Good show.
Okay.
Great show.
Well, I think that just about does it for us tonight. We hope you enjoyed this sort of year interview. Kind of.
I mean, we talked about the year.
Is there anything else that happened this year that you want to mention that was really good for you? I'll think. You guys think.
All right.
Dalton started wrestling. That was exciting.
Mandy met Justin.
I did.
Lindsay.
We're all going to say each other's.
And I got a new job.
That's true. That also happened.
I helped Manny get a new job.
He did do that. Smash Brothers came out. That was big for Jesse.
That's
true.
I became.
He got a new car.
That also happened.
We had a show on Fox for a while.
We did.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah, before my match aired, it got pulled. So that was neat.
Probably why. Thanks.
Jesus.
bitchy comment of 2018 goes to Mandy Kennedy.
Hold on, homie. There's still a week left. She can outdo herself.
Probably.
just step on my dreams. It's fine.
Everyone else does.
Yeah.
Just make yourself at home. All right, we're going to get out of here. Want to wish you guys a Merry Christmas from the Podzilla 1985 family.
No, she just said, leave my condom pocket alone to Jesse because he flipped up that little side one.
So I mean, that's about perfect size, and I can't think of much else that you could put there.
Because like, Justin asked one day, he's like, the fuck is that for? I was like, I don't know, probably condoms. It's like, what?
Which means right before she's going at it, she's like, flick.
Because you know like she's not dressing all the way down. They put candy in it. So that they can eat candy on the sales floor when they're not supposed to be.
Don't get naked?
Yeah, because you're cold.
Oh, no. I give myself a workout.
God.
Plus, it's her apartment. It's like 90 degrees in
Which
there.
Which means I got to stab my eyeballs out now.
You tried to talk about yours earlier and ruin our whole year with that.
But you're like my older sister.
Oh, well.
God, you never heard that, have you?
No.
Being someone's older sister for
no,
once.
That's really weird.
Oh, well, you guys ruined my holiday greeting. Thanks. Merry Christmas from the Podzilla 1985 family.
Hashtag give Hitler hep.
And we'll see you next year for more shenanigans. Well, Jesse on Sunday, but I'll see you next year for more of the shenanigans you can only get here on Podzilla 1985.
Hashtag kind of pocket.
I like how he acts upset, but you know he not.
No, I really got to end this show. We're going on 4 years in April. God damn, it's time to end this thing.
We're just now, like, we're finally starting to get those Facebook responses.
Oh, we're hitting our peak 4 years in, baby.
Let's just announce we're having a closing out of business sale.
We have had a business podcast.
Yeah. And then everyone will message us.
Yeah. Did you guys mention our
Tory Glass?
Yeah,
absolutely. We'll mention them again. But we also want to mention Zane Laney so it doesn't get lonely. Zane, you're still
no,
my love.
No, fuck Zane Laney.
No, man.
Yeah,
Zane.
Like, no.
No.
Oh, that's right. The Steelers thing.
Fuck Zane Laney. Yeah, we got beef. Steelers.
We got beef, Zane Laney.
He's
Zane.
A Vikings fan, which yeah, doesn't Zane. Really mean anything for the Steelers.
Zane, you got to remember
it don't
that
matter.
The three women on this show are all from Pennsylvania.
We got Zane. Beef, bro.
Just hit her up with the condom pocket. It'll be fine.
God damn it.
You owe me something. And it better be nice.
Yeah, Zane, I saw
you
so
better
I'm
find
about
some
this.
More cool Godzilla pictures.
Man, he gives a shit about that.
I don't.
Because they don't have, like, it's New Mexico, so they don't have a football team there. So, I mean, they just kind of branch out. Like,
because it's New Mexico.
I kind of thought that they would be, you know, like the nearby teams, but apparently the biggest ones, like the Dallas Cowboys make the most
Houston
sense.
Texans?
I almost said the Dallas Texans.
Texans.
I'm like, nope, that ain't right. But anyway, you know, the Dallas Cowboys are pretty big there. And apparently the Pittsburgh Steelers are oddly big.
Steelers
are
everywhere, though.
That's true. Yes. Steelers travel well, almost as well as Packers fans. Oh. But nobody travels as well as the Green Bay Packers. That's ridiculous. But anyway, because I had seen that apparently Zane is a Vikings fan.
Yeah, he shared that photo.
Yeah, and I like the Vikings. They're a cool team.
I only have one favorite football team, and I'm going to tell you what it is before we get out of here. It's the Arlen Longhorns.
There it is.
Merry Christmas, everybody. We'll see you on Sunday. Have a great Christmas. Have a great new year. Be safe. Love each other sexually, and we'll see you then. Later, Gators.